the story. Sometimes I just start talking about things, and later my friends will be like, did you have to say that, like, in front of other people? Before we came on this trip, Jay called me very conscientiously, like, called and was like, hey, I think totally, because this is my first time, I think I told you, it's my first time to be in Germany, in Holland, and, you know, I've been in the UK before, but I've never been to this country, and he was like, listen, it just occurred to me that you have never been to these places, and I just want to go over some stuff with you just to make sure you're prepared, you know, like, pack light because the cars are smaller, and, like, don't, you know, just, when you, you know, maybe take CDs instead of t-shirts because, like, you know, whatever, and just focus on CDs, blah, blah, blah. And he goes, listen, you know, you might want to think about your banter in between songs because, like, some of your humor might not translate. I kind of had to learn that the hard way. I'm not telling you what to talk about. I'm just saying, you know, you can't, you might not want to ramble on in between songs about things, and, you know, because they just might not get it, you know what I mean? And then whatever. So I was like, oh shit, like I really got nervous. I was like, oh my God, what am I going to do? Like I was going to Mars or something, and it was going to be like, hey, Mito, your leader, do you understand what I'm saying? You know, and it turns out, this is going awry.
You're really throwing me under the bus here.
That's not what I meant to do.
That's turns not out that they are people. They are people.
No.
You have senses of humor.
I know. Yeah. See, that's why I asked if I could tell the story. You take over.
I just thought, you know, maybe some of the, you know, the inside, there's like American inside jokes and maybe about Mississippi that you could right. say something about Mississippi and, you know, Oss Holland, and they might look at you and be like, I don't get it.
Yeah, which is totally fair.
But if you gave the same joke in New York City, it would just get an uproarious laughter. It's just too
different. Not necessarily. I've actually found New York people did this, mostly not get my humor at all. They hate everything. I tell you, I think New York City really is my least favorite place to play. Because I don't, you know, take myself that seriously on stage because I like to have fun. And they're just like, she's not together. Let's anyway, the point of me telling you the story in the first place was obviously not to throw Jay under the bus because he loves you and he meant nothing but to help me not make an ass of myself. But I grew up in the church, like I was telling you before, and I wanted to play a gospel song. And I don't know if you like gospel music very much or whatever, but we're in the church. So I just feel like we have to play a gospel song in church. That's just my feeling about it. When am I going to get a chance to play in a place like this? Especially now since they're not going to have shows here like this anymore, which is so irritating. But now I've only just found out about this place and I'm irritated. But anyway, this is a song, a gospel song I wrote for my family. It's called The Train That's Bound for Gloria.
Yeah.
This is my contribution. This is my way of giving back to my family, giving me so much. No love.